Hey Eagles!
I'm Abby.
I'm Andy.
And welcome back to this week's episode of Eagle Eye News. Lakes Has Talent, our annual talent show, is coming up. Sign up by scanning the QR code in the daily announcements.
We have two college visits next week.
On Monday, Calvin University will be here 8th hour, and on Wednesday, Beloit College will be here 7th hour.
Make sure to sign up in Maya Learning and get permission from your teacher 24 hours in advance.
The theme for Theme Out Thursday next week is camo, so make sure to show your school spirit.
Boys Bowling will be hosting tryouts on October 30th, 31st, and November 1st, right after school at Antioch Lanes. There will be warm-up days on October 28th and 29th, right after school as well.
Please register on the Antioch Athletic website. Last year, we only had one bowler from Lakes. Let's show D117 Eagles can bowl too. We hope to see you there.
D117 Gymnastics will have two open gyms at American Eagle Gymnastics in Round Lake on Wednesday, November 6th and Thursday, November 7th, 6:30 to 7:30 p.m.
The season will kick off on November 11th. Interested in joining? Reach out to Coach Blasinski with any questions.
Lakes Cheer has competition tryouts on October 28th. For more information, contact Coach Andre or stop in the main office.
Girls basketball will be hosting open gyms at 5 p.m. every Sunday this October. Stop by to get some work in before the season starts. Tryouts for the team begin November 4th after school. Anyone intending to try out needs to register through our school and have an active sports physical on file.
On Saturday, October 26th, there will be a Halloween car show and trunk or treat event here at Lakes. Check daily announcements for more details.
Perform your civic duty by joining the Democracy School team on Halloween during lunch hours as they walk over to the district office to vote early in this year's election.
Any student or staff member looking to register or check the registration status should contact Mr. Murray or Mrs. Reynolds.
Tickets to see the fall play are available for purchase.
Check your email for the link. The play will be showing tonight at 7 p.m., tomorrow night at 7 p.m., and Sunday afternoon at 2 p.m.
We checked in with the crew this week to see how the play is going.
Hey Eagles, I'm Jackson and I'm interviewing the crew today on the new upcoming show, Yellow Boat.
I'm Dylan DeWitt, I'm a sophomore and I am one of the assistant stage managers.
I'm Miles, I'm a senior and I'm on run crew, Scenic.
My name's Sophia, I am a senior and I'm also on run crew for Scenic.
Tell me a little bit about what you guys do in crew and what your responsibilities are for the show.
So basically I kind of control a part of the Scenic crew on what they do during the show. So if a set piece needs to get moved on, I tell them to go and do that.
We're both on run, so we move the set pieces, but in construction for the show, we use a lot of carpentry skills. Specifically for Scenic crew, we are the ones that build the set, that rig the curtains, that kind of set up the stage. That kind of set up the stage for what happens in the upcoming show. And then Scenic they're usually the people that are on stage while the show is happening, moving set pieces, moving flies in and out from the stage. We kind of work the show on the stage for the audience to see.
Also painting. Come paint if you like to paint.
How many people do you guys have on crew for this show?
So on my side, there's two assistant stage managers and they each get assigned the stage. So on my side, there's five people. And I think on the other side, there's also four people. So right now, crew of maybe 10 people for Scenic.
During the actual production, before we get to run crew, we usually have more people at least constructing.
Yeah.
And then you have to sign up and they'll look at your hours before you can get onto run crew. But normally we have probably 12, 15 people
per call.
Yeah.
So
the bigger the set, the more people, and 12 to 15 is not a lot.
Yeah. If there's not really a set number, but if you want to join theater, come join theater. There's going to be a job for you. There's going to be a spot for you. Whatever you want to do, you'll find your niche. So if you want to join, come join.
I'm Mr. Wiegold. I am the auditorium manager for District 117 and the technical director for Lakes Theater.
What does the crew bring to the show and what do you help do with that?
As technical director, I'm in charge of everything outside of the acting for the most part. Everything you see here behind us, this entire set, I direct all the construction of that. I design it, and it's all student built. How big and how grand we can go with the show depends on how many people we have to build it, and I design according to how many crew we have. We are doing Mamma Mia for the musical in the spring, and how big we can go depends on how many we have. So we want more people to join crew and learn building techniques, learn painting techniques so that we can go just absolutely crazy and make this one of the biggest shows we've ever done at Lakes.
Now check out the preview for the fall production Yellow Boat.
More to share from the Fine Arts Department. The fall concert is next Wednesday, October 23rd for Lakes Choirs at 7 p.m. Concert choir, a cappella, chamber choir, and jazz choir will all be performing.
The marching band and Halloween concerts are taking place on October 29th, with marching band performing at 6 p.m. and the Halloween concert following at 7:30.
Theater is also holding auditions for the Theater of the Mind radio play Dracula on October 24th.
This is a purely auditory performance, unlike any show we've done in recent history. Information has been sent out to all the students for auditions and how to join the team.
If you have any additional questions, reach out to Mr. Esquivel in the theater room or via email.
Seniors, don't miss the opportunity to order your senior t-shirt or sweatshirt. T-shirts are $15 and crew necks are $22. You must have your order in by Wednesday, October 23rd.
The purchase link and QR code is in the daily announcements and your email. If you're having any trouble ordering, don't hesitate to reach out to Ms. Cross with any questions.
Now let's throw it over to Caroline and Jackson with sports.
Hey Eagles!
I'm Caroline.
And I'm Jackson.
And this is sports. The boys' golf team won their last tournament of the year and Brady Cross was the individual champion. Brady Cross and Henry Stamulak are competing at this state tournament this weekend. We wish them luck.
Boys' soccer will play Antioch this Friday in a 2A regional at home for a 4 p.m. start time. Our record is 4-12-2 with wins against Highland Park, North Chicago, Grant, and Antioch.
Girls varsity tennis placed fifth in conference with highlights from Kaylee Anderson and Haley Easterberg winning first in their division, and Ava Price and Charlotte Roaming winning third in their division.
The cross country girls team have looked great over the last 2 weeks. They ran amazing at the Nightfall Classic 2 weeks ago with 14 athletes earning personal bests. Shout out to Hannah Salbilla and Brianna Guerra who both had great races in the top 20.
2 weeks ago, the boys' cross-country team took home their first win of the season at the Nightfall Classic. This past Friday, they took second place at their home invite. They are currently ranked sixth in the state. Great job, boys.
Both teams return to action at Grant this Saturday for the NLCC Championships.
Volleyball lost against Warren Tuesday, 1-2. They will be playing Lake Forest next Monday at regionals. Good luck, ladies.
The Lakes Esports Mario Kart team is having a great year and is currently 4-0. Last Tuesday, they defeated Belvedere North 3-0. Great job, Eagles. If you would like to see Lakes Esports, tune into the LCHS YouTube page Tuesdays at 5.
That's all for sports, Eagles.
Now let's throw it over to your Royal Rush for the Royal Rush update.
What's up, Eagles, and welcome back to this week's Royal Rush update.
Today we got boys golf going to state,
girls tennis sectionals at home,
boys soccer regionals at home,
the fall play, and football at Wakanda, theme strictly business.
On Saturday, we got boys golf at state, day two, girls tennis sectionals, cross country at Grant, and the fall play. Be there.
On Sunday, we got the fall play.
On Monday, we got girls field hockey and girls volleyball at Lake Forest.
On Tuesday, we've got
boys soccer at Vernon Hills.
And on Wednesday, we've got
girls volleyball at home.
Be there.
On Thursday, we got
Looking for a new cozy cafe this fall season?
The two of us and Caroline went to Something's Brewing Washington Street to give you an inside look.
Hey Eagles, it's Abby.
It's Caroline.
And we've got Andy here with our two friends, Kylie and Marissa. And we're here to review Something's Brewing. Okay, so we're about to order. We're going to rate it on price, speed of which it comes out, quality of the food, and yeah.
My Caramelicious Latte is here. It was $5.79 for a 16 ounce. This is about how big it is. It came out really quick. It came out within like 2 minutes. So I'd give the speed a 10, the price a 6, and now we're gonna drink up. The It's really good. I get this every time I come here, so I'm gonna give it a 9.5 out of 10 because it's a little bitter, but it's really good. I just like my coffee a little too sweet. This is the barbecue chicken sandwich. We got it in the full size and it was about $9. It came out pretty quick. I'd say it came out within like 3-4 minutes. Give the speed a 10 because it's a cafe and I'm kind of busy. The price is a little much for a full sandwich, so I'm gonna give the price a 4. I've never had this before. This is so gas. This is literally so good. I'm giving this a 10 out of 10. I've tried their soup. I've tried their sandwiches. This is their best sandwich so far. So we're going to give that a 10 out of 10.
Today, I got a Greek salad, a pumpkin spice latte, and the Greek salad came with garlic bread, and then I also got a side of potato salad. This was all like $22. It came out in like 15 minutes. Which is pretty good. For the weight, I'd give it about like a 7 out of 10, just because it wasn't the fastest, but it was still a good amount of time. And then for the price, I'd rate it like an 8, because I feel like this is a good price for a lot of food. Okay, I already tried the drink, and I give it a 9 out of 10. I really like it. I got it with almond milk. It tastes really good. I tried the garlic bread, and I give that a 9 out of 10 as well. I am about to try the Greek salad. So I give the salad like an 8 out of 10. I think it's pretty good.
Okay, now she's gonna try the potato salad. We're gonna wait for her to try it.
Overall, I'd give the potato salad an 8 out of 10.
So I didn't get anything, but I'm gonna crunch the numbers and get the average of all the ratings. So for the final ranking, we got 89.5 out of 110 points. We'd rate Something's Brewing at 81%.
So overall, we would totally recommend Something's Brewing to anybody looking for a cute cafe nearby. The prices are a little on the high side, but the food comes out quite fast and it's really great quality.
I could really go for that barbecue chicken sandwich right now. Looks delicious.
Seems like we'll be heading back to Something's Brewing sometime soon.
Halloween is coming up. Do you know what your costume's going to be, Abby?
Andy, we aren't going to be here for Halloween.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Well, at least Lakes has hosted some spooky events recently.
EEN sent out the camera crew to see what was going on. Let's check it out.
Hello?
Do you like scary movies?
No, actually, I think they're kind of trash.
Well, what about horror in general?
Not my thing. Have a nice day. Yes? Who is it?
Still me.
Bro.
Do you like school spirit?
I mean, I guess.
Well, you really don't seem to show it.
But you know.
Because I can see you with no school spirit.
Are you watching me?
Maybe.
Are you by chance watching me from behind the couch? I thought you were gonna
Anyways, that's all for this week, Eagles. Please send announcement requests or content ideas to EEN@CHSD117.org.
If you want more Lake Student Media, visit lakestudentmedia.com or follow us on Twitter at LakesEEN.
Thanks for watching and have a great weekend.